फ्रेंड्स, माई सेल्फ डॉक्टर प्रथमेश जैन, ऑर्थोपेडिक सर्जन. टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टेल यू अबाउट क्रैब बैंडेज एंड हाउ टू अप्लाई अ क्रैब बैंडेज. दिस इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉक एंड आई रिक्वेस्ट ऑल ऑफ यू टू सी इट कम्प्लीटली बिकॉज इट इज अ वेरी वेरी मच इंपॉर्टेंट एंड प्रैक्टिकली इंपॉर्टेंट टिप्स आई एम गोइंग टू गिव थ्रू आउट दिस टॉक. नाउ लेट्स टॉक अबाउट क्रैब बैंडेज. वॉट इज क्रैब बैंडेज? क्रैब बैंडेज इज बेसिकली अ रेडिश कलर्ड बैंडेज विच वर्क्स ऑन द प्रिंसिपल ऑफ कॉम्प्रेशन बैंडेज. इट इज मेड अप ऑफ कॉटन एंड इट इज ब्लेंडेड अप विद रेयॉन. सो इट फॉर्म्स अ कंप्रेसिबल टेक्सटाइल मटीरियल. देर आर डिफरेंट एडवांटेजेस ऑफ यूजिंग अ क्रैब बैंडेज. नंबर वन, द क्रैब बैंडेज ऑफर्स अ फर्म सपोर्ट टू द इंजर्ड और द पार्ट विच इज स्वोलन. नंबर टू, इट प्रोवाइड्स अ फर्म कंप्रेशन टू द एरिया. नंबर थ्री, इट प्रोवाइड्स वार्म्थ टू दैट पर्टिकुलर एरिया. एंड ओइंग टू ऑल दिस, दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट डिवाइस दैट वी हैव टू प्रिवेंट एनी स्वेलिंग ड्यू टू एनी इंजरी और एनी अदर रीजन. इट इज वेरी गुड मेजर टू कंट्रोल मसल स्प्रेन एंड ज्वाइंट पेन्स. देर आर वेरियस इंडिकेशंस इन विच वी कैन यूज अ क्रैब बैंडेज. सो वी हैव चार्टेड आउट सेवन मेन इंडिकेशंस. द फर्स्ट मोस्ट एंड मोस्ट कॉमन इंडिकेशन इज एनी ट्रॉमा और एनी इंजरी टू योर लिम. सो यू मे हैव एंकल स्प्रेन और एनी अदर एंकल इंजरी और एनी अदर इंजरी इन विच यू हैव पेन इन द स्वेलिंग in that particular area of the lower limb. So if you have that, you can use a crab bandage for that problem. Number two, there are some conditions in which you have swelling in your lower limb, like varicose veins or chronic venous insufficiencies. You may have what is called as lipodermatosclerosis, which is actually venous ulcers which are formed due to continuous high pressure because of the venous insufficiency. So in that particular case also, crab bandage works very well. Then if you have lymphedema, means if you have swelling in the lower limb because of lymphatic collection, lymphedema, then also you can use a crab bandage. Now I would like to bring to your attention that for these particular two indications, venous insufficiencies, varicose veins and lymphedema, crab bandage is good, but now we have a better alternative, which is a elastic stockings. So if you use elastic stockings, it is a better alternative over a crab bandage. Fourth most common indication is wound care. So if you have any non-healing ulcers or any big wounds on the ankle or the foot region, crab bandage works very well on the compression phenomenon. Then if you have any abdominal injury, so abdominal surgery, then you can use crab bandage on abdominal as well. And last but not the least, if you are in the post-operative phase, so if you have undergone any surgery which has led to increased swelling in the lower limb, you can use crab bandage nicely. So if you have any calcaneum fracture surgery, ankle surgery or any other surgery pertaining to the lower limb, the crab bandage will work very well as a compression stocking. Now it is very important about the tension that you put when you tie the crab bandage. So if you tie the crab bandage very tight, it may lead to compression of blood vessels and lead to a dangerous phenomenon which is called as compartment syndrome, and that is very very dangerous. So never use it very tight. If you use it in a very loose fashion, then you actually lose the purpose of the compression. And so it does not work. So it should not be loose, it should not be very tight. Ideally we say that crab bandage should be applied in a firm pressure. So this is a very very important thing. Now whenever you are applying a crab bandage, the technique to apply the crab bandage is very important. Now crab bandage is standard available in the market in four different sizes: 6 centimeters, 8 centimeters, 10 centimeters and 15 centimeters. The standard length is usually 4 meters. Now here what we do is, this is a 10 centimeter crab bandage, and here the child has suffered an injury to the ankle with an ankle sprain, and you can see that there is a swelling in this particular area. Going to tell you how to hold the crab bandage. You must hold the crab bandage like this. What people do mistake is people hold the crab bandage like this, and then it will be very difficult to apply. So always hold the crab bandage like this. Hold your two fingers like this and thumb and the index finger like this. So two fingers, thumb and the ring finger like this. Then you hold the crab bandage like this. Always leave the toe fingers free, and then apply two straps here. Now this is a technique when we use the crab bandage for an ankle sprain case. So he has suffered an ankle sprain, and we are applying the crab bandage for an ankle sprain. So we use two turns like this. Then usually the crab bandage is applied in an E version. So normally what happens in an ankle sprain, the ankle twists like this. So we need to correct it. So what we want to do is we want to dorsiflex the ankle and evert it as much as possible, and then tighten it like this way, and then on the leg bone we use two turns like this, and from here we'll go down again in this fashion, covering the heel pad this time, and here we will just cover half of the earlier compression. So this is a technique that we use when we are using the crab bandage for a ankle sprain injury. Now we have got two clips which we use to tighten the crab bandage in the end. So here is the final application. The position of the limb should be like this. This should be in right angle, dorsiflexion and eversion like this. You should not tie it in an inverted foot. So dorsiflexion like this, eversion, firm application of pressure. You should leave the toes intact, free. You don't want to cover the toes, and usually it should cover half of your leg. So if this is the length of your leg, this should cover half of the leg, and the pressure should be firmly distributed from foot to the ankle. And important thing is when you splint the device, so you make a figure of eight of the crab bandage like this. So the bandage which you cross it like this, this and this, the figure of eight application of crab bandage, that is very important. So if you use your crab bandage in this phenomenon, you will be very, very helpful for you to get a very good recovery in ankle sprain cases. Is any venous insufficiency, then how to tie a crab bandage? So now if you have a venous insufficiency, you need to tie the crab bandage from low to up. So first you will tie on the lowermost portion, and then you will tie, go upwards, covering 2/3 of the previous, and always hold it like this so that your rolling is very comfortable. So always cover the 2/3 of the upper margin and keep on rolling. Now the important thing here is never go from top to bottom. So you have to go from bottom to top. So like that you need to cover it completely in this fashion. So this is how we tie it from low to high for a venous insufficiency case. So friends, I hope that I am able to describe all the usage and technique to use crab bandage in detail. If you have any more questions regarding usage of the crab bandage, please feel free to write on the comment box. Thanks a lot.